Hello friends, welcome all of you back to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to show you how to fix Motorola startup fail error. When sometimes you are going to turn on your phone, you can see this message, or you can if you are going to boot into your recovery mode, you can see this error message, startup fail because of your boot image is invalid. So we are going to fix this error without using this RISC-I and smart assistant of which came to Motorola devices. Let's continue our video and see how to fix this error without losing any of data and internal memory on your mobile. First of all, you need to download Motorola USB drivers and passport drivers and TWRP recovery image. After downloading those things, you need to install passport drivers on your PC and also Motorola device drivers on your PC. I'm not going to tell you how to download and install those drivers, but I have pasted the download links on the description of this video. You can download those drivers from description links, and then you need to search, go to your start menu and search ADB. Here is the ADB.exe. Now click, right click on it and click on open file location option. Now we have on the ADB location. Now you need to paste your TWRP recover image in here like this. You can see I have already pasted my TWRP recovery image to this folder. Now you need to paste the shift button on your keyboard, left shift button, and right click on here. Then you can open command window here. Now we have opened our CMD window. Now you need to boot into your fast boot mode from your phone. Turn off your phone. After turning off your phone, you can press your power key and volume down key to boot into your fast boot mode on your Motorola device. Now I am on my recovery mode, but I can't show you because I don't have another camera at this time. So in here you can see AP fast boot flash mode, like this, like that kind of message on your screen. You can type here AD fast boot devices. Now here you can see your device. You need to unplug another all the devices from your PC before going to flash this recovery. Now type fast boot flash recovery. Now you can drag and drop your fast boot, your recovery mode, this onto this CMD window like this. Here you can see your boot image name and other things. Now click on enter.
Okay friends, here you can see I have made a small mistake of entering flash command on my CMD window. So I have entered the original command on the screen of this video. So you can follow that command and flash your TWRP recovery like this.
Okay friends, here this is the fast boot mode. Now you need to boot into your recovery mode like this. Now you can boot into your recovery without having any of error. Okay, it's boot into recovery. Now click on never show this screen on boot again, and sweep allow to modifications. Now go to backup option and backup the everything what you want to get a clear backup. Now I'm going to select my external data partition and also my I can't get backup from my internal storage from here.
Now you need to back up your data partition. After completing of backing up process of your data partition, you can back up it like this. Then press back button. You need to back up that things into your external storage, because we are going to wipe our internal storage too. Now go to this advanced option and go to file manager. In here you can see your external storage and also internal storage. Here is our internal storage. Now select the folders which you want to copy to external storage. Likewise, now if I want to download copy this download folder, I can go to that download folder and click here, then copy this folder option. Now go to external storage and paste into that download folder, into this folder. Now it's copied successful. Let's see if I successfully pasted that download folder into that alarm folder. Here you can see it's on here like this. You can copy that all folders and files likewise. After completing of copying process of your internal storage, if you want to copy full of your internal storage to external storage, you can follow this option. Go to here and find your SD card option and click this icon, copy folder. Now go to external SD option and go to another folder like this. Now click on this icon and save to copy. Here you can see your all files are pasted to this DCIM folder. Likewise, you can copy your internal storage. Now go to this swipe option and go to advanced swipe option, then clear Dalvik cache system, data and cache partitions, and sweep to wipe. Then press back from here and do to sweep to wipe option again, then press back button twice and go to format data option. Now tap on yes. Type on yes here and press enter button. Now your internal storage will be also formatted. Then you need to flash a custom, your favorite custom ROM here. Now I need to go to my external storage and select my custom ROM. I am going to flash this Pixel Experience custom ROM on my device. If you already didn't download the custom ROM before going to start this process, you need to download a custom ROM and paste that downloaded custom ROM into external storage on your device. After that, you can flash that custom ROM on your mobile and fix that error without losing any of data on your mobile. But if you are going to flash any of custom ROM, you need to get a clear backup of your internal storage and your data partitions. Okay, now you can click on reboot system option. Okay friends, now I have flashed successfully my custom ROM. Now I am going to try to boot into my recovery mode once again. I have power off my device and I am going to press my volume down key and power key. Now I am in the fast boot mode. Now I need to go to my recovery mode from here. Select recovery mode and press your power button. Now you can see here we have successfully fixed our problem without flashing stop from once again. So if you like this video, please subscribe my YouTube channel, turn on notification net and join with me.